Is Google's quantum chip the key to unlocking infinite realities? Did Google just bring the hammer down and presented a definitive answer on the question of parallel universes? Let's find out in today's video. Quantum computing is like stepping into a world where the rules of reality itself seem to bend and twist in ways that defy our everyday understanding. Imagine trying to explain to someone from the 1800s how the internet works. They'd probably think you were describing magic. That's the kind of leap we're talking about when we dive into quantum computing. And at the forefront of this technological revolution is Google's quantum chip, Willow, a device that's not just pushing the boundaries of computation, but also nudging us closer to some of the most mind-bending ideas in physics, like the possibility of parallel universes. To understand why Willow is such a big deal, we first need to grasp what makes quantum computing so different from the computers we use every day. Classical computers, like the one you're probably watching this video on, process information in bits. These bits are binary, meaning they can either be a 0 or a 1. Think of it like a light switch. It's either on or off, no in between. Quantum computers, on the other hand, use qubits, which are like the rebellious teenagers of the computing world. They don't want to be just a 0 or a 1. They want to be both at the same time. This is called superposition, and it's one of the fundamental principles of quantum mechanics. Superposition is where things start to get weird. Imagine you're flipping a coin. In the classical world, the coin is either heads or tails once it lands. But in the quantum world, the coin can be in a state where it's both heads and tails at the same time, at least until you look at it. This ability to exist in multiple states simultaneously is what gives quantum computers their incredible power. They can process a mind-boggling number of possibilities all at once, making them exponentially faster than classical computers for certain types of problems. But superposition isn't the only trick up quantum computing's sleeve. There's also entanglement, which Einstein famously called spooky action at a distance. When two qubits become entangled, the state of one qubit is directly linked to the state of the other, no matter how far apart they are. It's like having a pair of dice that always roll the same number, even if one die is on Earth and the other is on Mars. This interconnectedness allows quantum computers to perform complex calculations with a level of efficiency that classical computers can only dream of. Now, let's talk about Google's Willow chip. This isn't just any quantum chip. It's a 105-qubit marvel that's breaking new ground in the field. One of Willow's most impressive feats is its ability to reduce error rates as the number of qubits increases. This is a big deal because quantum systems are notoriously fragile. Even the slightest disturbance, like a stray photon or a tiny vibration, can cause errors that throw off calculations. Willow's advancements in error correction are like giving a tightrope walker a safety net, making it possible to scale up quantum systems without everything falling apart. As if anything we previously mentioned isn't interesting enough, Willow has demonstrated a computational power that's so far beyond what classical computers can achieve, it's almost incomprehensible. For example, it solved a problem in under 5 minutes that would take the world's fastest supercomputers billions of years to complete. To put that into perspective, if a classical computer is like a bicycle, Willow is like a rocket ship traveling at the speed of light. This kind of performance isn't just impressive, it's paradigm shifting. And this is where the idea of parallel universes come into play. One of the most intriguing interpretations of quantum mechanics is the many worlds interpretation. According to this theory, every time a quantum event occurs, the universe splits into multiple parallel universes, each representing a different outcome. So, if you're flipping a quantum coin, there's a universe where it lands heads and another where it lands tails. These universes coexist, but we only experience one of them. Some theorists have speculated that quantum computers like Willow might be tapping into these parallel universes to perform their calculations. The idea is that when a quantum computer processes information, it's not just exploring all possible solutions in our universe, it's exploring them across multiple universes simultaneously. While this idea is still highly speculative and not universally accepted, it's a tantalizing possibility that captures the imagination. To be clear, there's no direct evidence that quantum computers are actually interacting with parallel universes. What we do know is that they leverage the principles of quantum mechanics like superposition and entanglement to achieve their incredible computational power. But the many worlds interpretation provides a fascinating lens through which to view these phenomena. It's like looking at a magic trick and wondering if there's more going on behind the curtain than meets the eye. What makes this even more exciting is that quantum computing isn't just a theoretical exercise. It has real-world applications that could transform industries. For example, quantum computers could revolutionize drug discovery by simulating molecular interactions at an unprecedented level of detail. They could optimize supply chains, design more efficient batteries, and even crack encryption codes that are currently considered unbreakable. In other words, quantum computing isn't just about solving abstract problems. It's about reshaping the world as we know it. But as we marvel at the possibilities, it's important to remember that we're still in the early days of quantum computing. Building a fully functional, large-scale quantum computer is like trying to build a skyscraper on a foundation of jello. The technology is advancing rapidly, but there are still significant challenges to overcome, from improving error correction to scaling up the number of qubits. Willow is a major step forward, but it's just one piece of a much larger puzzle. So, what does all of this mean for our understanding of reality? Quantum computing forces us to confront some of the deepest questions in physics and philosophy. If the many worlds interpretation is correct, then every decision we make, every quantum event, creates a branching tree of parallel universes. It's a mind-bending idea that challenges our perception of time, causality, and existence itself. And while we may never fully understand the nature of reality, quantum computing gives us a glimpse into a world that's far stranger and more complex than we ever imagined. If quantum computing feels a little like stepping into a sci-fi movie, the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics takes that feeling and cranks it up to 11. This is the part where we dive headfirst into the idea of parallel universes, those possible worlds where every what-if you've ever imagined might actually play out. But before we start picturing alternate versions of ourselves living wildly different lives, let's break down what this theory really says. The many worlds interpretation, or MWI for short, was proposed by physicist Hugh Everett in 1957. And it's one of the most intriguing ways to make sense of quantum mechanics. Here's the basic idea. In the quantum world, particles don't exist in one definite state until they're measured. A particle can be in multiple states at once, what we call superposition. But when we measure it, we only ever see one outcome. Where do the other possibilities go? According to MWI, they don't just disappear. Instead, the universe splits, creating a new branch for every possible outcome. In one universe, the particle is in state A, and in another, it's in state B. This branching happens constantly with every quantum event, meaning there's potentially an infinite number of parallel universes out there. Now let's pause for a second. This isn't just about particles flipping between quantum states. If the many worlds interpretation is correct, this branching happens on every level, including the macroscopic world we live in. Imagine you're deciding whether to eat pizza or sushi for dinner. In one universe, you choose pizza, and in another, you go for sushi. And it doesn't stop there. Did you burn the pizza? Did you accidentally order too much sushi? Every tiny decision, every quantum fluctuation creates a new branch. The result? A sprawling multiverse of parallel timelines, each as real as the one you're experiencing right now. It's a fascinating idea, but here's the thing. The many worlds interpretation is still just that, an interpretation. It's not the only way to understand quantum mechanics, and we don't have direct evidence that these parallel universes actually exist. Some physicists lean towards other interpretations, like the Copenhagen interpretation, which suggests that quantum states collapse into one definitive outcome when measured. Others propose ideas like pilot wave theory or decoherence. But even if we can't prove the many worlds interpretation, it's incredibly useful for helping us wrap our heads around the strange behavior of quantum systems. And it's hard to deny its appeal. It's like the ultimate what-if scenario, but with the full weight of physics behind it. So how do quantum computers fit into all of this? Let's go back to that idea of superposition. When a quantum computer processes information, its qubits can exist in multiple states at once. This allows it to explore all possible solutions to a problem simultaneously, rather than one at a time like a classical computer. Some theorists have speculated that this might be evidence of the many worlds interpretation in action. The idea is that a quantum computer isn't just processing information within our universe. It's leveraging the computational power of parallel universes to solve problems more efficiently. Now, before we get carried away, let's be clear. There's no definitive proof that quantum computers are actually interacting with parallel universes. Most physicists would argue that quantum computing works perfectly well without invoking the many worlds interpretation. But the connection is an intriguing possibility that raises some big questions. If quantum computers are exploring multiple outcomes at once, does that mean they're exploring multiple universes? And if so, could they be the key to discovering whether parallel universes really exist? Here's a thought experiment for you. If parallel universes are real, what kind of choices or moments in your life do you think might have created the most interesting branches? Did you take up a hobby that changed your career, or make a small decision that led to a big unexpected outcome? Let us know in the comments, what's the one what-if scenario you'd love to explore in a parallel timeline? Now, back to the science. While the idea of quantum computers tapping into parallel universes is certainly fun to think about, there's another way to look at their incredible computational power. Rather than imagining them as gateways to the multiverse, we can think of them as machines that exploit the fundamental weirdness of quantum mechanics. Quantum superposition and entanglement allows these computers to solve complex problems by exploring all possibilities in a kind of quantum space. Whether this space represents multiple universes or just a probabilistic model within our own universe is still up for debate. But either way, the results are nothing short of astonishing. Take Google's Willow chip, for example. This 105-qubit powerhouse has achieved what's known as quantum supremacy, the point at which a quantum computer can solve a problem that's practically impossible for classical computers. In one experiment, Willow solved a problem in minutes that would take the fastest classical supercomputer billions of years to complete. That's not just faster, it's a completely different league of computation. And while this might not prove the many worlds interpretation, it does force us to rethink what's possible when we embrace the strange rules of the quantum world. But the implications of quantum computing go far beyond theoretical physics. These machines could revolutionize industries by solving problems that classical computers simply can't handle. For example, they could simulate molecular interactions with incredible precision, leading to breakthroughs in drug discovery and material science. They could optimize supply chains, design more efficient batteries, and even tackle climate change by modeling complex systems like weather patterns or carbon capture processes. The possibilities are as vast as the multiverse itself, and that's not just a poetic metaphor. At the same time, the rise of quantum computing raises some profound questions about the nature of reality. If the many worlds interpretation is correct, then every quantum event we observe is just one thread in a vast tapestry of parallel universes. But how do we reconcile this with our everyday experience of reality, where things seem so definite and singular? And what does it mean for our understanding of free will, if every choice we make spawns countless alternate realities? These are questions that go beyond physics, touching on philosophy, ethics, and even the meaning of existence itself. What's fascinating is that quantum computing doesn't just challenge our understanding of technology, it challenges our understanding of reality. Whether or not parallel universes exist, the principles that power quantum computers remind us that the universe is far stranger and more complex than we can imagine. And as we continue to push the boundaries of what's possible, we're not just building faster computers, we're opening windows into the very nature of existence. Thanks so much for watching and diving into this mind-bending journey through quantum computing, parallel universes, and the incredible possibilities they open up. If you enjoyed this exploration and want to see more content like this, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell icon so you never miss out on our next deep topics. And as always, stay insanely curious.